Your first musical experiences, how did you first become interested in music?
I see. You see, strictly, I belong to a musical family. My father was a musician, Devesh Abhavadar, as he was called, known. My grandfather was a musician, Vengadesh Abhavadar, properly known as Vengich Abhavadar. And my paternal uncle also, he was a vainika. My father played violin and had a very beautiful voice. He also sang. And that is the formation which gave me a very strong instinct to take up music like this.
Your father actually taught you music then?
Of course.
From the before you can remember?
I had a very strong instinct and I insisted my father. Though he did not very much like to accept myself and all that, he wanted to take studies as such. Those people believed in studies and all that because they thought music might be very tedious and all that in future. He told me, why you sing for yourself? Then anyway, I wanted serious coaching. Then he began. And by the age of 10 or so, I used to sing a few krutis only, but ragam, swaram and all those things came almost naturally, by lakshya.
Did you begin singing for weddings when you were very young?
Weddings?
Yes.
No, no some temples and all that, very private parties, even in my school days. And later, that too, my father stopped, not to have unnecessary exhibitions of a small boy. He wanted to get me matured later.
He wanted you to be an engineer or what?
Some sort of general education and enter some office. Because he didn't have much education in those days. So he was enamored of education and the office and all that. But anyway, I had my high school days and college days. When I finished my graduation in Victoria College, even then my father did not want to take music. Though I had come to a very decent level, even to perform for a couple of hours and more. Chambai Vajna Bhavadar and all those musicians, they were interested in me. They wanted me to even become their disciples. But somehow or other, I had my own view that I should have a bit of modern approach to things as well as the traditional way of musical life and studentship to get a very orthodox and traditional and scientific understanding of things. It was a bit of a dream, I can say. But somehow or other it came to fruition. When I was thinking seriously like that, they started in Kalakshetra, Rukmini Devi, with my master.
You came to Madras actually to study music or
correct,
to...
Correct.
No.
I came to Madras to have a very serious course of music and have a very strong personal touch of things.
But you already had gotten your BA in science?
I had finished.
Mm-hmm. In what field was it?
Physics.
In physics?
I was a physics student. Uh-huh. And then I came to Kalakshetra and naturally they had started the Sangeetha Shiromani course. I was the only student and my master was here at, after Annamalai University, he came here.
Had you heard of Tiger before? Had you ever heard him sing? Or?
I had heard about his name. Just when people, my father and other musicians used to say, oh, there's a great musician who is rather a musician of musicians. And people should hear his music. Though he was not actually for a platform, like a platform musician type. He was an authority in music and so on and so forth. They used to talk sometimes. So I had only hearsay of things. And it was my good fortune and privilege to come like this and to be very close to him for a number of years like that. Very close to him and of course Kalakshetra atmosphere and all that. It was very, very natural and...
You were together every day, I think.
Almost together. Though I lived with my parents used to follow me. Yes. Like anything in my high school days, college days, in Kalakshetra life.
So you were their only son, weren't you?
Yes, I was. I am the only son. The four or five children died very young and myself and my only sister survived. So naturally my parents were very much attached to me. So they followed me like anything. So even in Adyar, I was here in nearby village, the next street we used to, that house. Yes. Very next street there. Mm-hmm. Yes. We were there.
You mean where the Theosophical Society is?
It was a society quarters. Mm-hmm. In fact, they gave me as a student very, very nominal rent and all that. Mm-hmm. They were very considerate because I was a very qualified student and all that. And they were very watchful about my progress. They were almost all those seniors in those days. They were all very much interested.
It was like a close family.
Close family. Oh. And my master also developed a sort of father and son relationship. Naturally, I had also that sort of parental regard and much more. And he knew from the very beginning, in fact, that his type of music, though he had numerous students in the music academy, Madras University, and Annamalai University, nobody could ever go near his style. All simply gazed at him and simply paid tribute.
He had a very unusual style then.
Unusual style.
No one could imitate
it. Very unusual style, very individualistic.